Welcome back to Vegas Live with Ninon. Well, I just had a fabulous time with Evan Davis. He's quite amazing. He's now my competition. He's not my competition. He's a great guy. And yes, many years, yes, and many. And yes, I have Lisa Gay with me. And how are you?
I am doing well.
This woman always looks amazing.
Bless your heart.
You do. You always look absolutely fabulous. Does it take you long to get ready?
No.
How long does it take
you? No, because I can't handle taking all day long to get ready.
So how long does it take you all day long to get ready? She's like looking at me like, I know it takes you all day long.
Don't you start.
No, but you're looking fabulous.
Thank you.
So what have you got coming up? What have you done? Lots of stuff going on.
I'm so excited about my Phyllis Hyman show. It's called The Songbook of
Phyllis Hyman. How fabulous. Mm-hmm.
And of course, Phyllis was Clive Davis's top artist at the time during the 70s. She came out, of course, when Angela Bofield and Gene Carn and Grover Washington and all that.
Time.
Yeah.
It was very hard to come out.
Quiet Storm. That was the Quiet Storm group that came out.
Quiet Storm.
Earth, Wind, and Fire, whole thing. Yeah,
yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. And all of them came out in Los Angeles, where I'm from. You know, it was just
I lived there many years.
Yeah, yeah, and she yeah. was she was top of the top, creme de la creme, as they say.
Yes, and, of course she was.
And she was just an amazing artist and also amazing.
Was she an inspiration to you?
Yes, she was. Yeah. Yes, she was. Okay. Yes, she was.
Because you were a young girl then.
She was it was junior high school when she was out there with her things, yeah. And she also was very progressive when the AIDS piece came out, and she yeah. did a lot of fundraisers in Las Vegas especially as yeah. well too, yeah. Yeah. And she was a huge actress.
Because when that came out, when the AIDS thing came out, everybody yeah. was petrified yeah. and worried. And
yeah, absolutely. She and Diana Ross really took it to the next level.
And they took it, yes, mm-hmm. and they helped mm-hmm. tremendously.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And she was a songstress in yeah. her own. Piece for everything yeah. from her own work and her work also.
But she also gave back, you know, yeah. and I think a lot of this, especially in the entertainment mm-hmm. business, mm-hmm. we always mm-hmm. seem to want to give mm-hmm. back. I think mm-hmm. because we're sort of kind mm-hmm. of grateful mm-hmm. for where we mm-hmm. are, that we kind of get recognized and somebody sees yes. us and they like
yes.
us.
Yes, and she came, she had that spirit in her heart on top of that too. And so when she came out and did all that, she also, during her period of time, from her musical pieces all the way through her going on to Sophisticated Ladies, on the Broadway musical there, and of course she went in New York, and she was nominated for the Tony, and also won.
You know a lot about this woman.
I know a lot about her.
Because she's your inspirational.
Very inspirational, and of course she passed away. She took her own life.
At the end of it,
she did. She took her own life. She had a concert at the Apollo with the Whispers, and she ended up taking her own life. However, her spirit and her music
is still around.
It's still moving and grooving around.
And
so Tony and I had talked about that for years, to actually do a songbook for Phyllis Hyman. I finally was able to do it at the Summerlin Performing Arts back in October, on October okay. 30, which was fantastic, as I opened for smooth jazz guitarist, Billboard number one,
this
Adam
woman's very famous.
Oh, it was cool.
Cool, you like that.
And then the last weekend, I was with Kelly Vaughn and
yeah,
Amanda
Kelly
King.
Vaughn, and I was supposed to be there.
I know.
I apologize.
A very Vegas Christmas, yeah. which was fun.
Which was good.
Which was a lot.
Well, Kelly Vaughn's, she's amazing as well.
We had a great time.
You had a good time together.
Yeah,
we had a good time together. Absolutely mm-hmm. amazing. Mm-hmm. Now, this library in Summerlin,
yes.
the arts library, seems to be getting very popular.
Very popular. All the libraries are.
Why?
Because
Tony was just
yeah,
one of them.
Absolutely. All the libraries are because the establishment of having new lighting, and they have some sophistication going on as far as that is concerned.
Yeah.
And they're beautiful places, and the capacity is perfect
yes.
for what a lot of the locals and even the jazz artists
can
come
down there.
Yeah,
a lot of local people can go
and
there
the
rather than going
artists.
Onto the Strip,
absolutely.
Where
absolutely.
The Strip is also always
absolutely.
Very, very busy.
Absolutely.
And also it's very expensive because they charge for parking
right.
and this
that's
and that
right.
and everything else. So
that's right.
people
that's
avoid
right.
that. So
that's right.
they found another.
That's
so
right. And the promoters that are coming in from out of town, especially the jazz promoters, are finding that to be very support, you know, very
really?
Huge for them. Yeah. As well. So the libraries are
And
are
then
beautiful.
You don't charge as much.
No.
So no. To go to a show on the Strip is very expensive.
Very expensive.
I'm not knocking it because it's right. You know, it's an experience. Right. It's a beautiful experience. Right. It's absolutely fabulous.
Absolutely.
But for the locals and the people, there's sort of anywhere from what is it, 25 to sort of 50 or
$50, right?
Yeah, $50.
Somewhere around
there,
depending
on
what. Yeah, depending on what's being done, who the artist is that's coming in and out. But they're booked. You know, you can't even hardly.
So
get
your
a
last
state there.
Show, how was that? Did you experience that the people are coming back out again?
Well, what has happened with the Phyllis Hyman is that we're now in talks right now to take the show to Atlanta and Philadelphia from her hometown, where she comes from, taking it on the road. But we will be doing a show here, and speaking of, I have my Christmas show here right around the corner from here with Uli Geissendoerfer.
I want to go to that. Can I go to that one?
Let's
oh, my goodness.
Let's
I'd love to go.
It's kind of all
and when
together.
Is that?
That is this Friday.
Oh, this Friday.
December the 10th at 8 o'clock, 2031.
Write all this down, Maria, because we've got to go and see this show.
2031 Sunset Road at 8 o'clock. And I'm really excited about that because I'm presenting, of course, our Christmas CD. And I also have special guest John Wiedemeyer on guitar.
Okay.
And Ramon Phillips,
okay.
Who is from the Lady Gaga's Piano and Jazz Orchestra. And, of course, Uli, of course, Angelo Stokes, Dickie Reeves, and just, you know.
Them all.
Yeah.
You've got them all coming out there. That is
fun.
This Friday.
That's this Friday.
At 8 o'clock.
At 8 o'clock, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
What was the address again?
2031 Sunset Road.
2031 Sunset Road. What's the name of the place?
And it's the Gatsby at Gambit in Henderson.
Okay, Gambit and Henderson. Oh, I know where
Gatsby,
it is.
Yeah. And that used to be the old Eastering, where all the big bands used to play.
Oh, really?
It's the same building, but it's been remodeled.
So it's all been remodeled.
It's all been remodeled.
Redone and
redone,
everything.
Yes.
That is, isn't there a piano, a jazz, the jazz pianist there is Uli, isn't it?
He's the director.
He was the director. He was on my show a couple of weeks ago. This guy's amazing.
In fact,
my producer and I were there.
Yeah.
We were there a couple of weeks ago. Mm-hmm. Absolutely beautiful. Mm-hmm. You know, I've got to come up.
Oh yeah, we're gonna have tons of fun.
Absolutely.
I know what we're doing the first set, but I don't know what we're doing the second set. We're just gonna.
Just funny because there was a girl there. I forget the name of the girl that was there, but her first set was very calm, very lovely. The second set was astronomical. Mm-hmm. It was just amazing.
Oh my
goodness.
And
they all got together and they all started. You know, it was just incredible.
Yeah, it is the new highlight spot and the really cool thing from. Tasha Como to Linda Woodson to Joel and all these guys that are on it. It's absolutely fantastic.
She's great PR, isn't she? She's giving a shout out to everybody.
My girls,
absolutely. Get them all together.
Yeah.
That's the basis of my show is getting people like you
and
everybody out there. I don't have any competition with anybody, though everybody's trying to open up a talk show like mine, but they'll never be like mine because they're not going to have this crazy woman.
There's only one Ninon.
Which is great. We don't want any more, believe me.
We need our parts, don't we?
We're in our seventh year now, actually. We've been
Isn't
doing
that
this
something?
It
yes.
is to be able to do something like this for 7 years in Las Vegas is really something. And I didn't realize it was that big, but it's so funny because everywhere I go and I'll put my hat on, no makeup.
Right.
But the problem is one problem. I start talking. Oh, that's Ninon. Oh, no.
They can't miss you. But you know, as you know, with the timber. That's going on in Las Vegas now. You know, with the timber of everything musically wise.
Yeah.
I mean, all of the entertainment that is off Strip, which is absolutely just blowing up.
Yes, it is.
And that's why we have these wonderful promoters who are coming in here now, and we talk.
They
about
can see
and all the rest, and they see what's happening.
But they see what's going on. Like you are a big inspiration out there, especially in the jazz department and that whole arena. But you also help others because you've got the drummer, you've got the guitarist, you've got this, you've got.
Oh, yeah.
And so all this sort of integrates together with people like you promoting them and everything else.
Yeah, we have to do that. We have to do that for one another.
Yes.
We need to do that. And it keeps the energy moving and grooving.
Yes, it certainly does. In all your years of performing, what must be one of your greatest epitomes? Like, you know, well, I made it, I'm here, I've done it. What was it?
I think the Phyllis Hyman show.
Oh, really?
That I just did was because
that,
was, that was that was the one of the grandest things I've done as an entertainer, as an artist, yes. because her music is so
I know you're an
beautiful
animal,
and,
yeah,
and complicated and it meshes together.
Yeah,
and
what about Billie Holiday?
It's beautiful.
Billie Holiday, do you ever?
No, I love Billie Holiday and Ella and Sarah and Nancy and all the rest of them. All of them. Carmen McRae, I love Carmen McRae.
You do them all.
Of course, I do them all. And of course, Tony played with like half of them.
Yes.
So so having the experience of being with him, and then also the textures and different things about the not only their voicing but the arrangements, because the arrangements are what's happening.
And I'm always mm-hmm. confused as to you have the lyrics to a song mm-hmm. and then you have to have the arrangement. I don't think how come every single song, even jazz, anywhere you go, mm-hmm. is different.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
How can they make mm-hmm. so many different songs? I guess the arrangement just kind of creeps in, doesn't it?
Well, you know what? If it's a standard arrangement, it's one thing. You know, it's like, you know, read the ink. Like my husband used to always say, you know, read the ink or know the ink, and then you can do whatever you want to do. And depending on the players, the group of players that you have with you.
Because they're all going to play differently.
And you're going to always, but the thing is, the grand thing about it is when it all comes together and it fuses together, now that's
well,
jazz.
That's yeah,
jazz, that's see. And the feelings and the emotions, and then you can feel, and you can actually feel it on stage, and you don't even have to look around, you can just hear, and just the ears open
know,
up and brings everything together.
Because mm-hmm. it is, you know, mm-hmm.
and it's
doing,
fun.
And it, yeah, but you're all going in there together, and he plays, and then he plays, and yeah. she plays, and she sings, and it's like, you know, it's like a little, it's like a magical touch.
Mm-hmm. My husband used to say, people used to always say to him, oh, you're such a great jazz player. He said, no, I'm an R&B player, I just know the rudiments of jazz.
See, there is a difference. R&B and jazz.
Even though they open up both worlds, but they're just they mesh together like that,
which is amazing. Yeah. If you could give a message out there to any young jazz singer coming up right now that are not quite getting out there, or they're having a hard time, or what would you say to them?
I would say go and sing wherever you can. You go out and sing wherever you can, whether it be your uncle's party, an event, and especially for nonprofits.
Okay.
Especially for nonprofits, because
it's a
fantastic
and
feeling.
And you're giving back.
And you're giving back, yep. And there's tons that come out of all of that. Yep. You know, I remember doing a little nonprofit, little barbecue thing that Tony and I did, and then we ended up doing an event for the congressional session of Congress, right, at the Anaheim Convention for over 3,000 people. And we were able to bring our nine-piece band
in there.
And
you brought your nine-piece band.
Nine-piece band in there.
Were you nervous doing that? I bet you were.
No, it was fun.
Oh,
it was a lot of fun.
You don't get nervous at all, do you?
I do, but I get nervous like weeks ahead of time.
Weeks
ahead of time.
Before you're getting
right.
better.
And then once I get down to the nitty-gritty, then I'm pretty much locked in.
And then you're happy.
Supposed to do it. Yeah.
You're relaxed, you're happy. I've got this thing together.
Yes.
How can anybody reach you?
You can reach me on Facebook, on Lisa Gay's page, or you can just go to Lisa Gay on Facebook, or you can just hit me up at LG Thrill. That's LGTHRILL 43 at AOL.com.
I love it all. I love it all. Do you rehearse every day?
No. I rehearse up here.
So this mind's going continuously. So do you ever sleep?
I do, but when I'm thinking about things like, you know, with the show coming up,
yes,
where we did a different presentation, of course, with five horns and all the rest of that. Well,
yes,
then we're having
course.
A whole another different presentation because of the players.
The
that we
players
have
you
us,
have in there,
us,
and then you've got to remember all their names because you're going to introduce them one by one.
I do that at the top.
Yeah, you don't have name tags.
I do it at the top. No, I just do it at the top.
You do it at the top.
Because people should enjoy the players.
Yes, they should.
You know, and rah-rah the players.
Yeah, absolutely.
And know them and say, hey, Angelo, hey, you know, you guys are cutting up or whatever case may be.
So you get them out there. You get all that over with before you.
Oh, yeah. I say, listen, we're in family. That's why I have two projects to my heart, which is the Phyllis Hyman songbook.
Yes.
And Lisa's Living Room.
Oh, Lisa's Living Room.
So that's what
Lisa's
this is. Lisa's Living Room.
Lisa's Living Room.
And Larry Carroll, who is in Berlin or Prague or somewhere right now, is my producer on that, and we're doing that. We're going to be shooting that live again too, coming up soon too. So I'm excited.
She's got all this energy and all this stuff. Well, you're certainly in the right town for it, aren't you? She's certainly in the right place. Absolutely amazing. Lisa Gay is just amazing. I love this woman. Unfortunately, I didn't go to your show, but let's hope I can go to this one.
Yeah, we can go to this
one. We're going to make sure I get to this one.
Come on to this one. We're just going to have a ton of fun.
That's right.
And talk a bunch of you know what.
And this is going to be great.
Absolutely.
And a new venue, the Gapsy.
At the Gatsby, this is going on all over town, and there's I think there's another one. Have you been to
room? Right, that's why. Oh yeah, that's right around the corner from me.
The Vegas
Kelly
room.
Has her.
Yeah, Kelly's got her Thursday. I was there last Thursday.
They have Christmas show and all the rest. They have all that.
So a lot of different things opening up all over town, which is becoming where the locals and everybody can.
Right.
And the locals do support.
That's right. And then one more piece I have to put in there, which I am so proud of. That I have been designated as the ambassador for the Liberace Foundation.
Oh my goodness.
So right now we are at what we call the Liberace Garage, which is located at 5115 Dean Martin, right down the street from Allegiant Stadium.
Yes, I know where you are.
And we are in the Hollywood Cars building, and the Liberace Foundation has the Liberace Garage, which has all the beautiful, wonderful cars. Beautiful cars and artifacts from Lee, as we like to say, as you know, with Lee. And then we are going to be also opening up after the 15th, another 5,000 square feet, where we will be soaring his costumes in. You know, like he would soar out of the car.
Well, I often wondered, he must have been very, very strong, because those costumes were heavy.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes. But you know how he used to say it.
You know, he might not be with us, but he certainly is not forgotten.
He is definitely not forgotten, and you're going to hear more and more and more about Liberace. Go to Liberace.org or Liberace Museum Store, because we have some great stuff that is bling from Liberace.
Is this from Liberace?
This is from Liberace.
Talk about bling bling.
$39.
Use pride of
rich. $39. Look at that. Look at that bling for $39, y'all.
$39.
And with me showing that too, we will also have a trunk show going on
Friday night. She's working up now with classic. Go on.
We're bringing in Jonathan Warren, who's the CEO, is bringing in one of the Liberace new cars, not the old, the new cars that we utilize for touring and also for rentals for all
you
sorts
rent,
of things.
So you can, whatever
so you can do whatever you want to do and whatnot, but
well,
he's going to bring one of those. We're going to open the show up and all
you,
that.
Wouldn't he?
I would just love him to. See, Tony spent time with Lee. But I never had the opportunity to meet him, except sitting up and when my parents brought me here and my brother here to years ago as preteens. At the International Hotel at the time, they came to see Barbara Streisand.
Yeah.
And coming in at that time was going to be Elvis. But sitting down after breakfast, waiting for my dad, here comes Liberace going this way, and there goes Bill Cosby going that way to the tennis courts. Right?
I'm sitting in the right spot.
So that's when I first saw Liberace.
Amazing. Thank you so much for coming
Thank
on the show.
So
absolutely
much.
Amazing.
I love coming on with you.
Absolutely
you know that.
Amazing. Yeah, we're Amigos Taco, obviously Cantina, absolutely amazing on Pico.
Food
and
is great too.
Pecos.
By the way.
I want to say Pecos. Pecos and
Pecos.
Russell.
Pecos and Russell.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely amazing. They have a buffet here every day. It's I think it's $13.99 if I'm not mistaken. I always get the price wrong, but if I practice. We get it right. This place is always busy. I mean, it's 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. It's always busy here. Fabulous food.
It's great
we'll
food.
Be right back. Vegas Live with Ninon for our next guest. Take care. Thank you.
See you later.
Waking up. Every morning by your side, I never dreamed that I would ask you to say goodbye. We promised that our love would last forever, yet we can no longer stay together. Don't cry.
'cause I'll be singing you a love song from heaven.